Okay, let's make sure these numbers are correct. It's video 191, it's Thursday. That's correct, we're working on the Virgo table. Okay, that all looks good. Okay, so let's get to it. Now, I'm tired of explaining things, because I'm just tired. So I'm just gonna get to work here, and if somebody, you know, pops in, I'll stop the music and I'll actually kind of explain what the heck I'm up to, but otherwise, I'm just gonna try to enjoy myself, drink my coffee, and do my thing. So, with that, let's just get to it. Thank you. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, it gets up for about a minute.
Okay, hold on.
Especially that standing thing. initial once that brand new got out.
Oh, I see.
That the screw? That this one? Or lock this one. That one was on, this one was off. I found the other screw for it. I put it in, but then the part laid off.
Huh?
Radio,
I don't know, I think it'll be okay, I guess.
Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, shit. Hey, sorry, I just saw that. What's my bitrate doing here? Oh, that's okay. I just saw that. Because I really need to get some type really need to get something like that. I don't know if there's such a thing. But that would be very helpful, because that happens to me quite a lot. You can set sound notifications for when somebody mentions you in chat with BTTV. Uh-huh. Yeah, so I don't know, I just guess I'll have to pay attention. Yeah. Yeah, there seems like some options. It said BTTV. What is that? Better Twitch TV? Better Twitch TV. So Better Twitch TV, it looks like chat notifications, but somebody would have to literally say, I think somebody would have to actually literally say, like, you know, at Kanji Coder for me to actually, you know, hear the notification, judging what I just read. It looks like something, you know, worth looking into. That's just gonna distract me, right? It's like all those things that you could do, all those possibilities of the things that you can do. You can do anything, but you can't do everything, right? Yeah, so, yep, you can do anything, but you can't do everything. So it's like, yeah, okay, figuring that out is probably not too hard, probably maybe 30 minutes to an hour of my time. But you kind of get nickeled and dimed by stuff like that a lot of the times. It's like, those little things, they all kind of, like, add up. Yeah, well, for now, I'll just try to pay attention. I don't know how long did it take me to respond, by the way? I'm just curious to know, because I have it on a monitor. Like, I can see the chat on a monitor. It's just that, like, sometimes I don't notice the, okay, so it didn't, okay, so I think maybe subconsciously I must have picked up on the change on the screen, even though I wasn't consciously aware of it. But yeah, I try to keep it on screen, so it's there, but it's not on the screen I'm focusing on, right? It's up on my top monitor, and then the code I'm working on is on the bottom monitor. Oh, by the way, after a minute, okay, that's still kind of, it's fast, but it's not fast enough, right? Like, you really want, like, what? Like, you know how, like, with web design, it's like you need, after 3 seconds, people go somewhere else, right? So 3 seconds is kind of like, is kind of what I would be aiming for like something acceptable. Now, since, you know, you already know me, so 1 minute is probably good for you because you already know me, right? But if it's like a stranger, if some random person's just stopping in the stream and they've never seen my stream before and they want to know if it's interesting enough to, like, watch ever, that's going to be a problem, right? Because they don't have enough investment to stick around for a minute to see if I respond. But anyways, I'm working on astrological symbols, right? So I think you may have seen this yesterday. So I'm trying to make a table with like all the different astrological symbols. And I'm designing all the symbols with code, right? So all these symbols are parametrically designed. Yeah, you said you were going to use Java, right? I mean, whatever gets it done, right? Whatever gets the job done. Right? I mean, there's the perfect way you want to do something. And then there is the way it actually gets done. Right? And, 1 hour, that's excellent. It's interesting how, like, sometimes productivity sometimes does not happen in a very linear fashion, right? Sometimes it's like, it can be like all day, nothing productive, and then in 1 hour you just like make like huge, huge amounts of progress, and then you kind of like wonder to yourself, like, how come I can't just always have those huge strides of progress in like small amounts of time? Though that's kind of like saying, you know, I can get down on the floor right now and I can do, you know, 50 push-ups, and then you could say, oh my god, I did a huge amount of exercise in such a short amount of time, why can't I do that all the time? And the answer is, you know, your muscles get exhausted. With Win32, I spend 2 weeks with nothing productivity. Yeah, Win32 is difficult stuff. Yeah, like, it's not a... It can be very difficult. So my Win32 code looks like crap because the Win32 code is so difficult for me. I kind of like kept I've written Win32 code multiple times, and so when I want to start a new Win32 project, I kind of cut and paste code or reuse certain library code I've already written for Win32 to get something working. But yeah, Win32 just can make things a pain in the ass, right? So if you don't need everything done in like C, and you don't need everything kind of done to that crazy optimized level, then don't do it. And you can still get OpenGL in Java. Yeah, so I don't know what you'll use to get it, but I know there's definitely many libraries that'll let you do it. Like I think SFML is an option. A lot of bytecode stuff is actually really fast now, which is kind of like scary, because like, man, it's like the advantage of, well, a lot of the speed advantages of C code don't necessarily happen from, right? Like, when people say, is language A faster than language B? Sometimes the fastness actually comes from the way people have to write code, right? Like, in C, you kind of have to write code in a more optimized way, just because C makes it very hard to overcomplicate things. As long as you don't do things overcomplicated in Java, yeah, you can get pretty fast Java code, which surprised me. But the same thing with Go. Go is a compiled language, isn't it? It's a compiled language with a garbage collection. Whatever gets the job done, right? Because at the end of the day, when you're trying to show this off to somebody, they just want to see that you can code, right? They want to see that you can actually put something together. It loaded 5,000 earthquakes in map really fast. Oh, that's pretty awesome. Like, that's some pretty cool stuff. Like, I think that's pretty cool. I definitely want to see that when you're ready to show it. Obviously, I'm gonna guess that like right now you got the data and maybe like a crappy looking UI and you still have some time to where you want to make it look better. But when you're ready, yeah, when you're ready, show me, because I actually do want to see that. You don't have to show me right now. You can show me whenever it's like polished enough where. But no, yeah, exactly, yeah. Like you got the basic functionality, but it's like it's something where it might impress me right now, but it won't impress people who don't code. You know how that's so annoying, but you know how like in any profession, there's things that impress normal people, and then there's things that impress people within the profession, you know what I mean? Like, EMSC have a public WebSocket, so I will do real-time visualization. Awesome. Now, what does EMSC stand for? What's that? I'm not familiar with that. I'm familiar with WebSockets. I mean, I don't really program WebSockets, but I'm familiar with what they are. And let me make sure I understand what WebSockets are. WebSockets are just basically, you know, you keep the connection between the client and the server open, right? It's a continuous connection, right? So European Organization for Earthquakes. Okay, I'll put that in my notes. So let me go over to my notes for a second. So you said, let me just put that in my notes here for a second. So EMSC, and then EMSC, okay, next time I ask, I'll be able to find it. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Yeah, the project is for geology and physics. Nice. Now, are you doing this? On a contract basis, or are you doing this to get a better? Yeah. Now, is this for the current job, or is this like to make a portfolio to like get a better job? I'm just curious, because like. Most of the time when I'm doing something that's actually awesome, a lot of times it's, you know, it's just for portfolio because to get, yeah, awesome, awesome. Yeah, I mean, the more stuff you have to show people, right? The more stuff you have to show people, yeah, I mean, take your stuff that's, you know, take your stuff that's fun and, you know, put it in a portfolio, right? Because it's really a matter, once you have like a really good portfolio with cool stuff in it, it's just getting it in front of the right eyes, right? I want to apply my knowledge on physics, yeah. And also, yeah, the more disciplines you mix together, the more unique skill set you have. Yeah, so there's, God, I wish I had, I mean, it was years ago, it was like 5 years ago. So this is, I don't know what it's like, I know you're one third of the globe away from me. I forgot exactly where. I know you have a gigantic park in your city. I feel like the name starts with a T, but I can't remember where you are. Where I am, or where I used to be. I used to be in Seattle, Washington, in the United States. And I used to do, like, a whole bunch of, like, swing dancing and... Albania, okay. So I'm totally... Albania and then the city had a T in the name. But anyways, I am going to get to a point here. Okay, Tirana? Am I pronouncing that right? Tirana, yeah. So... Because you're talking about, like, science and the lack of software. I was at a blues dancing thing, and somebody I was dancing with, I mentioned I was a programmer, and they mentioned that they needed somebody to do, like, programming for optical stuff, for, like, so they needed an optical physicist kind of person to do kind of software for, like, laser optics or something. So, like, there are software jobs definitely out there that kind of mix and match physics and programming. But also, there's definitely a good, optics was your favorite? Oh, I gotta go, unfortunately I'll never find that person I was talking to, because this was like 5 years ago. But yeah, like, if I had a degree in physics at that time, that lady I was dancing with would have gave me her email, and I would have been set up for a job interview, right? So there's, if you can do it, if you can get a, I mean, I guess it's, we're in a pandemic, we're in a plague, but, I guess for the future, If you're one of those people who is able to break out of your shell a little bit and do those kind of social things, they can be really good for finding leads in terms of, like, job prospects. And it's really like it's a numbers game. It's like a statistics game, right? You just talk to a whole bunch of people, and eventually, if you talk to enough people, you're going to eventually bump into somebody who has the ability to offer you a job. I have had more than one job that resulted from just going out to nightclubs and, like, making conversation. It kind of seems like people don't think of it that way, because people probably just think, oh, you just go to a nightclub and you try to get laid, right? But I swear to God, like, if you actually just talk to other people... and just have random conversation, and you can find some people who can offer you jobs. Now, it might differ by your city. Like, if you have a more college-y town, that might be more true, right? Because the education level of the populace probably affects that. But I personally, I've had good luck. But yeah, I mean, you know what? I bet I could find somebody who, I think I have a family member or... I think I have somebody like that who does optics programming. But yeah, talking around can really help. Anyways, I'm gonna get back to the code and stuff. I mean, I'll keep the chat open if you have anything else to say, but I'm gonna just get back to listening to music and coding and trying to get this kind of design finished. Because it's pretty close to finish, right? It's like, well, I mean, I guess you'd have to know what that astrological symbol is, right? Or you'd have to know what the Virgo astrological symbol looks like. I've been looking at some reference. This is almost done. But we need to... This little thing right here, we're going to get rid of some of this stuff. And... All right, cool. But yeah, I'll just be doing my stuff. And if you have any questions or whatever, I'll be around. But yeah, I'm just desperately trying to get some stuff, because right now on, like, Etsy, I need to also get an Amazon shop working. But, like, on Etsy, like, every day I've been lowering the price for the stuff I've been selling by a dollar. And eventually I'm going to hit a price where it's impossible to make a profit. Like, I'm getting very close to that price. And if that happens, actually, let's put this off screen for a second. Let's not... let's just go like this. Okay, let's just go to Etsy itself. And, like, so I have, like, a whole bunch of acrylic. Oh, yeah, 1 a.m., yeah, it's probably time for you to go to bed. Yeah, I have a whole bunch of acrylic, and there's, like, 9 sheets in here. And, I keep on lowering the price by a dollar every day. But shipping costs, like, at least, like, $12, so if I offer free shipping, once I hit $12, I'm not making a profit at all. Well, even before that, because the material itself that I'm selling costs money, right? The case that this comes in costs me, like, $2 or $3 just to make, right? And this bigger thing, right? So I'm just gonna keep on lowering the price and then see if I can do this. Okay, you're gonna stream tomorrow? Okay. So I may or may not be up, but, if I'm up, I'll come give you a visit. Yeah, but I can't guarantee it, because, I have a chaotic schedule. And it's something I need to get in line. I don't know. I don't know what I need to do with my life. Chaos seems to just be the way that I do things. But yeah, if I'm around, I'll definitely stop by. But, and just feel free, like, if you're streaming and you want to just come in the chat, in this chat, and tell me you're streaming, that's fine. Like, I don't care, alright? Like, you notice, like, I only have one rule in my chat, right? There's only one rule, and I do mean that, right? Just tell me what's on your mind, and that's all I care about, right? I don't like how a lot of, you know, a lot of Twitch streams kind of have, like, these very authoritarian rules. I would like to keep my stream kind of relaxed, you know, like, you know, I don't know. That's just me. Maybe I'm, what do you call it? I don't know. That's just the way I want to do things, right? So, yeah, if you want to just stop by, I don't care. I don't care about self-promotion. If you just want to tell me you're streaming, I'll come check you out, you know? Okay, anyways, I'm gonna get back to it. For reals this time, I swear. Okay, so we just finished the Virgo symbol. And because we have that finished, we want to take a screenshot and we want to start a new stream, right? So we're going to try to do kind of like one stream per astrological symbol, right? So that one looks good to me. So file, save as, and let's just call this Virgo.png. And then also let's kind of like look through the little slideshow of all the stuff we have, right? So let's look at what we currently have now, right? So we have Aries, Cancer, Gemini, what is this, Leo? Okay, do we like that? Yeah, sure, that's pretty good. So Leo, Virgo, actually not Virgo, sorry. This is a bull, so this is Taurus. Okay, so this is the Virgo thing we just worked on. It's like, I just worked on it for like 2 hours. You'd think I would know what it's called by now. Now, hold on for a second here. This rounded part, I don't know if that's acceptable. So let's look at other things, right? So if we look stylistically, we have curves, but the lines end with, like, straight perpendiculars, right? Okay, so we're not quite done. We're close, but that's not acceptable. So we gotta chop that down. Just because stylistically, that's not quite right. So let's just do a little bit more editing to get that to work, and then we'll be done. Okay, so my bad. Let's keep on going. Thank you. Okay, so that's better. That's a little bit better. Just because it's more consistent with the style that we already had. So we're going to go up here, and we're going to comment reload no, because that will screw me over. I've made that mistake before. So we're going to move this, right? And we're going to remove the debug from here. So we're going to set that back to 0. Okay. And now we're going to open up the main folder full of the cutting paths. We're going to re-render Virgo 1 function. Now technically we already have the source material we needed, but I want to actually render it from the file responsible for it. Right, so virgo01.scad is going to be from whence virgo01.svg is rendered from, right? So even though it's the same exact geometry I was looking at earlier, I just want to do it this way so that, well, first of all, just to make absolutely sure it's correct, right, that file actually does what I think it should do. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the only reason why. So yeah, that looks good. So now the next thing is to just open this up and change that screenshot. So, right, so it's slightly different, so snip that. And we're just going to put this over here like that. Just take it. We don't really care about cropping it perfectly. And then file, save as. And this one is going to be virgo.png. And we're going to replace the old one. Yes. Close. Close. Okay. So now let's go look at the top level kind of screenshots of everything we've done so far. Looking good. Okay, so I'm kind of satisfied with that. So we're going to keep on doing this. Why does this one look smaller? Oh, the line looks smaller because we're zoomed out more. We can see the circle surrounding these, but we can't see them on these ones, right? Yeah, so this looks good. Let's just keep on going here. And just keep on adding all these zodiac symbols, because this is pretty cool stuff. And, yeah, we'll do what we can do, and then, maybe the final design, maybe we will, put, inside the wheel, we could probably put all the other astrological symbols smaller, and then, right, the astrological symbol that is the feature of the table is, like, in the middle, right? So, we're good here. And I think I hear my food beeping, so we're at a great time to stop the stream. So I'm going to stop the stream, and I'll work on the next astrological symbol, which is Libra, next, after I get back from eating or whatever.